Hello, hello.
Oh my god, this is so epic. This is I'm Emily Casey. I'm the host of Staten Island Locals. That is what you're listening to right now.
My name is Matt Foronjy from the Parallel Lines.
And he's on the show right now.
This yeah, is so we're live. Epic.
So yeah, tell us a little bit about yourself, what you do, and what is so Staten Island about you.
Well, I play in a band from Staten Island called the Parallel Lines. Played outside of Staten Island. I play the bass in the band right now. Do guitar a little bit here and there, some songwriting too. But play a lot of live shows. We got more music coming out. You know, we just have a good time with it. We enjoy it.
Super fun.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, of course. Well, I'll ask you some on-the-spot questions.
Ooh, here we go. A little bit later.
But yeah, what's your favorite song that you like from the Parallel Lines?
Probably have to say Supernova, honestly. That was one of the first songs, you know, as a trio before our good friend Angel joined. Great guitarist, awesome person, by the way. Shout out to him. But yeah, he joined a couple months ago, but before that we started in 2019. Me, Andy, and his brother Aaron, you know, they've been playing together since they were younger. So when we first started jamming together, literally the first day we all met, the first thing we played, it was the main riff for Supernova, basically. and I remember, I still have the video on my phone of that. And I go back, I'm like, damn, it's crazy to see, like, you know, where it really all started kind of for us, where it started moving up a bit.
Yeah, it's awesome. So this is Supernova by the Parallel Lines. Hope you like it.
Enjoy.
Supernova.
Yeah.
the speaker just got really loud, but that's fun.
I'll stay back for a bit.
So Matt, no, talking to it. Yeah.
What's going on?
Because the levels are good for them. They're just loud for us. But yeah,
that was Supernova. Hope you enjoyed that one.
I have a very important question for you that I've asked many people on this show, and I need your opinion.
Ask away.
Is a Pop-Tart a ravioli?
Oh, my God. I heard you and Andy arguing about this last time.
What is your take?
And I heard his take, but I'm here to say that it's not a ravioli. Definitely not.
Why?
You can compare it all you want, but two different things.
Okay, and but soup and cereal. Soup and cereal.
Soup and cereal? Okay, that's a little bit more understandable. That's a little bit less of a stretch, but still, no, I'm sorry.
Nah, the cereal one, that one's real. Tori agrees with me.
Soup, you need SMH. More stuff than that.
SMH my head. Okay, on the topic of food, this is one that I've also been asking people. If the Parallel Lines music was a meal, what type of food would you say that it was?
Just imagine eating the whole Halloween basket at once.
Yeah, like all candy.
Just every flavor you can imagine.
Yeah, every like piece of candy, and then you're like, ugh, now I have to throw up.
Yeah, after a while, I guess, with anything, right?
Yeah. But yeah, so out of like all of like the bands, like not the bands, all the shows that you've played, what has been one of your favorite shows that you've played?
That's a good one, actually.
Yeah,
to think.
I told you I was gonna put you on the spot.
Good, I like that. But I really like playing at Mother Pug's in the summertime, actually. I like the setup they got back there. They have that back lot, you know, it's closed off. Got an elevated stage. Got the sound system. It's nice in there, you know?
Yeah, I like that place.
Otto's Shrunken Head in Manhattan. That was cool. It was a smaller spot, but, you know, they got the real grungy vibe.
Yeah, and they were like, Angel and Aaron can't come in.
Oh, yeah. They gave us a little bit of a hard time, but we convinced them.
Yeah. Well, yeah. So, yeah. So I know that you played with Scum Shots at Otto's, right?
Yeah. I think they were doing it for their EP release. No, I think they were shooting a music video that night, actually. I forget for what song, but I was in the music video. I was in the crowd moshing around. Yeah, they're another great Staten Island band, honestly, you know? We played with them a couple times. Great guys, fantastic musicians, and their music is something different, definitely, too. I like their vibe they got going on. Something unique out there.
Yeah.
Good band.
Yeah, so that was my segue into playing. This is Dissociate's Degree by Scum Shots, epic Staten Island local band. Let's go.
Big Staten Island vibes.
Big. Ooh. scum shots. Let's go. Valid. But yeah, more questions. Matt, how'd you get into music?
Well, originally, I started playing the saxophone, actually, in elementary school in fourth grade. Damn. But yeah, that was really how I got into it. I always listened to music before that, like from my parents, my brothers, whatever was around, really. But that's how I got into like actual musical training. And then about eighth grade, I was like, all right, I'm kind of done with this instrument. I was getting tired. I switched to bass guitar, which is kind of like a weird choice, most people would say. But I liked it. It appealed to me. So I got into that. I was 13. Yeah, it was eighth grade. Damn. A long time ago now. But yeah, then I picked up guitar a few years later too, and still going since.
Yeah, what was the first song that you learned on the bass? Do you remember?
Your Blues by the Beatles. Super simple, but something good to learn on, you know?
Yeah. Because I also play the bass, and so...
Yeah, I was going to ask.
Yeah. My first song was... What is it? Talking Heads, Psycho Killer. That was my first song.
That's a good one.
And it was really, really hard for me. But I learned it because my teacher was like, you remind me of like the bassist from Talking Heads. And I was like, okay. And he was like, you should like learn the bass. Manifested it. Yeah, he was like my architecture teacher. Like he wasn't like, I never took a music class. He was just my architecture teacher. He was like, you should like play the bass. You'd be like super cool.
Bass is super underrated. Come on.
It's so underrated. I love the bass. It's so fun because it's just like bonk. It's like bonk, 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 bonk. Yeah.
Yeah. You got your own bands too, right?
Oh, yeah. I have No Chances with Tori and John and Scotty. And then I was in another band called The Concept of Oranges.
Oh, yeah. I remember seeing them on Instagram, yeah. Definitely.
And we kind of died a tragic death, and my drum set is still at my friend's house.
I was going to say, would you set it on fire or something?
No. It was just like, we just, like, grew apart, sadly.
Nah, things happen, definitely. I mean,
yeah.
People got their own things. And
I'm like, I want my drum set, though. It's
yeah,
fine.
I feel like with music especially, though, it's something so subjective, you know? If you're there trying to force it or not trying to be genuine to yourself, honestly, it's not worth your time, you know? Or if you're not trying to contribute to a genuine vision, like in a band, per se, you know?
Yeah.
It can get toxic, too, you know? There's a lot of different things that can happen.
And then it's like, have you had any, like, you don't got to put anybody on the spot. I'm just saying, like, have you had any, like, band situations?
Now we putting everyone on blast right now. No, I'm kidding.
You're actually I hate the parallel lines. I hate every single one of those lines. All of the lines. No. But yeah.
No. Never anything like that, really. Thankfully, you know, we're all pretty gracious dudes. We don't, we're not here for the BS. We're just here to make good music and
very
have a good
nice.
Time. And it works naturally. It's a good thing.
So wholesome.
None of the lines are crooked.
None of the lines are crooked. Bruh. So, like that song. What was, like, one of, like, the first, like, I don't know. I'm forgetting what I'm saying. talk about your inspirations.
The
What's
band?
Your inspirations?
The band inspirations, or?
Or yours.
I mean, a lot of classic rock stuff. It was just, when I was growing up, a lot of the stuff I was hearing around me. Not that I so much listened to the music, but I heard classic rock from my dad, rap from my brothers and stuff. And then pop music from, like, my mom on the radio. So it's like, over time, I'm finding more and more inspiration. I'm, like, realizing where all this stuff comes from, kind of. And, like, it's interesting to see your musical journey, I guess, quote, unquote. Yeah. But the band inspirations, you know, it's everyone's collaborative idea. So, honestly, you'd have to ask the rest of them. You'd have to get them in here for that. But 1975, that's definitely one of our biggest
ones. Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
that was so funny.
Them.
We were in the station once, and the 1975, they were like Twitch streaming like their performance at Madison Square Garden. And me and my friends were just sitting around, and it was like the week before Andy was supposed to be in here. And I was like, and what's the main guy? Do you know the main guy's name?
From the 1975?
I don't know, people love that guy.
I was going to say, it's slipping my mind right now.
Isn't it like Matty Healy or something?
Yeah, Matt Healy, I think.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And we were watching him, and I was like, bro, that's just like what Andy does. Like, I was like...
Oh, yeah.
I was like, Andy just like looked at this guy and was like, I'm inspired.
Him and Aaron, they love the 1975. Yeah. Respectfully, you know, they're an amazing band, super diverse, like something different in today's music scene, definitely. But a lot of our music comes from there. They got catchy stuff, honestly. Like, they're always putting out catchy tunes. They put me on.
I don't listen to them that often. Actually, I don't listen to them at all.
Slacking.
Well. Eh. Welp. Maybe I'll listen to them. Maybe.
Yeah, we could put something on.
Yeah, we could put 975. Do you know any of them?
Well, we actually cover one of their songs.
Yeah.
For one of our shows.
Which one?
You Somebody to Love. Looking for Somebody to Love.
Oh, looking for somebody.
Yeah, I was gonna say, go back to their page. Yeah, right there.
Yeah.
Certified bop.
Explicit. OMG. That's inappropriate.
Oh, no, we can't do that.
That's inappropriate for the radio.
They don't have a clean version?
Yeah, where's the clean version of 1975?
Come on, 1975.
This is disgraceful.
Shout out Deke, I know you're watching. I
oh,
saw
Deke's
your snap.
It's Deke.
Hey, yo.
It's him.
Yeah, that's our boy Deke. Andy's boy. He met online He's from Texas.
Found him on the internet.
Yeah, he came up here, did a couple songs with us. He's on our song Black Hole. They have another group too, actually, Grandma Drinks.
Yeah.
Definitely. They don't have any music out yet, but
they
if you could see them
they
live.
They need to get that.
Yeah.
So then we can play it. Bruh.
Y'all are dope.
We're looking at the Gov, their Bandcamp, because we're like, they don't have Spotify. And they said that their full album is on the way. Stay tuned. I am tuned. I'm staying so tuned.
We've been tuned. It says July 27th, 2018. Come on, where's it at, boys?
Bruh. Their picture, that was really cool.
Yeah, they got some dope music. That's another dope band from the island. Every time, you know, we're playing with them, I love to watch them play, you know. The guitarists, all of them, they're all insane musicians.
Yeah, I feel like I've seen them actually a lot because I would go see you guys and then they were playing.
Yeah, and they would usually close out the night.
Yeah, that's fun. I think I've seen you guys a total of, I have actually wrote it down. I have this list where I write down every movie that I've ever seen and I write down all the shows that I go to. So I've seen the Gov twice, and then I've seen, where's Parallel Lines. I've seen, guess how many times I've seen you guys?
How many?
Guess a number. Say a number. Any number.
I can't even fathom a number, honestly, because I feel like you've been at most of them, you know? I don't know how many shows.
I've been to like 20, 95% 30, of them.
30? No, not 30. How many have we done total?
I've been to 12.
Okay. That's still a good amount.
Yeah,
definitely.
But that's like a freakish amount. That's compared to like everyone else on this list is like once, twice.
For a local band.
Once, 12. I seen you guys.
True fan.
I saw you guys 3 times in 2019. If you want to know.
Oh yeah.
And then twice in 2021, because 2020 didn't exist. And then 2022. I saw you 7 times so far.
Yeah, these past 2 years, 2021, 2022, have been real good to us. I mean, getting shows seems like every weekend pretty much, or at least getting offered them.
Yeah, it's epic. I made like for the Staten Island Locals Instagram, at Staten Island Locals. Look it up, at Staten Instagram. Locals Instagram. I made a calendar of like most of the shows in December. Obviously, I miss some because I'm not perfect, except I am perfect, obviously. I put like all the posters that for like the stuff in December, because I keep getting confused. I wanted to like promote all the shows in December, like on this show. And then I was like, there's too many. I'm confused. I don't know them.
Yeah, you got the calendar now.
You know. And there's the calendar. You
could put it up on the Instagram, on the website. Makes it easier for people.
Calendar has all of them. There's like...
It's dope that you're even doing that. Like, I mean, 7. More organized than me. Sometimes I don't even know when our own shows are. I'm like, oh, wait, we're playing this Saturday?
Yeah, it's like, I think there's literally like 10 coming up. There's Battle of the Bands semifinals, which is gonna be crazy because it's the four-way, like it's Figurehead, Gamma Ghouls, Vega Maestro, and Pastel, and like only one is gonna survive, or right
battle to the
or
death.
Two or maybe it's
some
two.
Dope bands. I mean, the only one I haven't really seen is Figurehead.
Yeah, I haven't seen them either. Actually, I haven't seen any of these.
Vega Maestro.
That's another dope group. Yeah. But yeah. And then there's going to be... I'm definitely going to try to go to that one with my friend. And then there's the sweater one.
the sweater party.
One. Yeah. The
worst holiday sweater.
Worst holiday sweater. Christmas sweater party. Worst holiday sweater party. That one, you're playing.
Yeah.
And Goon Dads. I've been meaning to see them for so long. Yeah, I keep their music, like, I really like their instrumental stuff. And I just, like, I like to open the show with it because it's like, and then I'm like, hey, is that on level?
Opening credits.
It's fun.
We haven't played with them yet.
Yeah?
No.
I like them. I got really confused. This is pronounced audit, right? Like when you're auditing something?
I guess. Like I was going like to say IRS. A weed it.
A weed, a weed it? Because it's like audit. Like audit. I don't know. I don't really know.
Yeah, these. Come on Spans. Out though. The Saturday, know, the 10th. Motherpug Saloon.
That's going to be so epic.
Yeah, it'll be a good time.
Motherpugs. So I'm excited for that. Then there's Marvin's graduation party.
Yeah.
I have a cap. My graduation cap. I still have it, so I'm going to wear it.
I have mine from high school, but that's about it.
When you guys play, you can wear mine if you want. My graduation cap, I put all like patches on it. Cuz on my school bag, I literally covered the whole thing in patches, like over the course of the years, like it was 100% covered, and people knew me as like the person with like the patches backpack.
Walking around with the bag just jangling with all the patches on it.
And then I switched. I when I graduated, I took a bunch of the patches off to put onto my graduation hat. And so now my bag doesn't have patches anymore because it's on my graduation hat.
It's dope, though. It makes sense.
Yeah. No, that's fun. Then there's also this one, the December 23rd, you're playing with Scumshot, Slay, and Bad Answer. And is Who Killed Marilyn another band?
No, I think...
Or is it just like a question? Because I don't know who killed her. I don't know why they're asking me.
Is it the female-fronted Misfits tribute band, or...
Oh, yeah. Is that the name of it?
Poster's a little confusing, Jeff.
I've been looking at this poster for a while, and I'm just like,
it's dope.
It is dope, but I just got confused. Either way, it's gonna be fun. Yeah,
it's dope that you got everything on this page, though. Yeah. Honestly, it's like you don't see a lot of people doing this. And I think you said it on one of the other shows you were having. There's not enough mediums for artists out there a lot of the time.
Yeah, I think that that is so true. Because I, like, everybody, like, has their own stuff that they're promoting. One thing that I think is crazy is that the venues don't promote the shows. I think it's insane.
Yeah.
What do you mean? Like, why don't they post it on their Instagram?
Yeah, honestly. And a lot of the time, you know, I'll tag them and they look at it. They don't.
And then they're like, cool.
I don't know who's running it. I could understand.
Flagship Brewery is the only one who promotes their stuff. Like... Juicy Lucy has like 1,000. Or like Mother Pugs, you have a stage.
Yeah.
Like promote what's going on your stage, please. Like in the nicest way, please.
Hey, it doesn't hurt. I mean, you know.
Yeah.
You only bring more people in. And there is a scene for this on the island. Don't underestimate it. There's a lot of people out there who want to hear this stuff.
Every single time I see a show, there's always like a band that I don't know. So I don't know for the Christmas party at Juicy Lucy, the Mele Kali Kamaka. I don't know what that means, but like the Hawaiian one. I don't know Sidereal Sun. I don't know that band. Do you know them?
I feel like I've heard of them, but no, I don't know their music. I know Silkstone, of course, Jacuzzi Fire. Silkstone.
Slay. On the Uncertain though, do you know them?
No,
I have
play with them,
I'm
actually.
Like one of the only people who know them. But you want to know why?
Why?
It's because their drummer was my best friend from, like, middle school's brother. And I have a big scar on my knee because I used to run. Me and my friend, we were running into his room and throwing Legos at him and running away. And then when I was running out, I stepped on a Lego and fell.
It's always the Legos.
And I cut my knee on his, like, glass, like, dresser knob. Oof. And I have, like, a fat-ass scar on my knee.
Oh, damn.
It's all his fault. I'm kidding. But, yeah, so that's Chris. And, like, I feel like more people need to know them. They promote a lot on, like, TikTok, which is really fun.
So, yeah, shout-out to Uncertain.
Shout-out the Uncertain.
See if I can pull up to that show.
They're fun. Yeah, I'm going to try to go to that. Because also my mom wants to go to support. Because...
You gonna pull up with your mom?
Yeah, I mean, I've known him since I was in kindergarten. So
yeah,
like
family friends.
Yeah. Then this is Open Jam, Flagship, Curious Volume, and On Pink. You know On Pink?
Oh yeah, of course.
I went to high school with those guys.
Yeah, I remember them.
Oh yeah.
I remember they were playing, like, since they were real young, you know?
Yeah.
And we played a couple shows with them. We played Marvin's Party, well, two Marvin's Parties with them.
Oh, yeah, true. Yeah, yeah, both of them.
Yeah. 2020, 2021.
Yeah, that was fun.
Yeah.
And then, like, we, like, the first one, like, we, like, cleaned up the church after.
Oh, yeah. That was fucking awesome. We had it.
And, like, mopped the church.
Yeah. And it went pretty good. Everything was clean, I think. There was one spill on the floor that they had to clean up, but
yeah, we
had
someone, a tarp down. Someone threw up in the corner, not on the tarp.
Don't worry, it wasn't a holy day.
But yeah, this one's going to be at, like, Dock Street. I'd never been there. We have classic Battle of the Bands. And then this one.
Grandma drinks.
Grandma drinks.
No, that's dope, though. Motorhead, you got Best of the Misfits, Best of the Ramones. It's a good lineup, you know? If you're on Staten Island or if you're coming through, whatever you're doing, you got nothing going on, you know, you could just pop out to any one of these bars. Like, they always got shit going on.
It's so true.
Yeah.
And there's, like, stuff that, like, in between all the shows, too, that I don't even talk about. Like, they got, like karaoke nights and, like...
Yeah, they have open mic.
Like yeah, there's
yeah,
like a
the comment
open
that
mic.
There says open mic at Flagship.
Yeah,
December
15th. Open mic, Flagship, yeah. Local fish show.
Fish show.
This has like rappers on it. This has rappers on it. There's this guy. Okay, there's a whole backstory I have with this guy, but I'm not gonna get into it. Do you know? You probably don't know him at all. Intel. He's in the like Wu-Tang like second gen Wu-Tang.
Intel.
He's like Method Man's kid.
I think I've seen him. I didn't know that was his name, but yeah, I know who he is.
Yeah, his given name, his like legal name is probably not Intel.
Oh no, I hope it's not. Honestly,
imagine it is now, and you hypothetically hears this, and he's like, "Yo, that is my name, though."
Hey, shout out Intel.
Shout out Intel. There's a whole story that isn't fit for the air. But I know him. I don't know. He's playing the show with Local Fish. That's what I'm trying to say. Where is it? Where's Local Fish? Local Fish. I love the name of their band, Local Fish. They lost the perfect. Their Instagram is Local Fish Official. They should just called it Local Official.
Yeah, honestly, you missed out.
That's fine.
I love their logo.
They're getting more into like hip hop side of stuff. That's also what I was trying to say. I just got distracted by like my flashback. But I don't know if this is Sir Clifton or Staten Island Railroad Clifton. Cause like Sir, like Sir Clifton.
A double entendre.
But, yeah, Intel, I don't know, KDHN.
That's dope, though.
Yeah, this is their cool poster.
They're leaning more into the hip-hop stuff.
Yeah, it's fun.
We do a little bit of that here.
I've listened to Local Fish a little bit, and it's like, it is a little bit more hip-hop-y. So that's slay.
So that's Staten Island rap.
I've been trying to, like, get, like more, like, Staten Island, like, rap stuff in here, because it's all super punk. You know?
Yeah, I feel that. I mean...
Because I know that there's rap out there. Because, like... I know about... Like, there's all, like, Wu-Tang and all that. And then there's a bunch of people who have been, like, inspired by Wu-Tang. And, like, that's,
yeah,
like,
definitely.
A whole separate scene. I know Dock Street, like, they have, like, pretty big, like... Like, rap scene coming from there. And I knew this guy... who used to, like, record there all the time. And he was like, you want to come? And then I didn't. But I kind of wish I did, because then I would have, like, had that connection, those types of connections now. But, yeah.
Yeah, well, look back at it.
Yeah. You know. Let's play a song.
There definitely is a lot of rappers on the island. I mean,
oh,
I
yeah,
see a lot
secret.
Of them, but...
They're like
maybe
hiding.
I'm not aware of the scene as much, but I don't hear about it as much.
Yeah, I don't think I think it's because they're not playing shows as much.
Yeah,
you know, like I wonder, like, do they like where they play shows?
Yeah, I imagine the shows would have a little bit of a different vibe to them, you know?
Mm-hmm.
They feel like
untapped resource of hip hop on Staten Island.
I would definitely tap in, city folk.
And yo, tap into that Staten Island rap scene. Bruh.
And we could put on a rap song.
Put on Kanye? No. Not Kanye. I have Local Fish on here. We can play them. Let's play Go Fish by Local Fish.
I need a J-Jibs type beat.
Yeah. I burst out the ice, reimburse me twice, cut all the lights, crack all the pipes, cause my patience is thinner than quarter-inch pinstripes. This challenge harder than cinnamon, spice rack height. Innocent flights from here to there, I share, I care. You can only bear the burden of weight. Atlas, with a child in your stomach, you seem more like Gaia. At last, nature plucked your attire, you're meant to inspire. Spiral out of control, roll, I roll, you troll, I troll, you fold, I won't. These poker chips feel too valuable. I know I've been leaning casual, lateral notes. Noticing if we're compatible won't do any harm, my charms work. But hold on a minute, I choke when it comes to showing my true colors. Since I'm a blues brother, all I see is red. I'm down, I'm blue, brother. Can't see ahead. High beams highlight where I fled. This glare is too spread to look. This road I'm shook, I booked it. Caught the hook, say Candyman ain't too quick. Lucid dreaming, putrid cleaning music. Loosely in the booth, I thought I'd lose it. Picturing your frame, no Stanley Kubrick. Cool kids throw up deuces, I'm two fuses in. I'll move a mountain a cubic inch, then drop the beat to preach these petty messages.
Corners of Pop-Tarts when they're mostly bread. I like the corners of the block dark when they're mostly dead. Ghostly crevices in book bags and backpacks. Back of my head, covered in scribbles, middles and notebooks, covered in riddles of who we really are, abstract. As a matter of fact, I don't give a duck about abs and ass slaps. Floor shake the money, but it don't crack glass on my TV. Pull the brakes, don't wanna go that fast. Read me, feather and stones are the bind. Heavy, but slacks are behind. Sweatpants, if you get me, catch me running for my shit. Grab an oven mitt, buy them out the pan like a hot chick. No dick and no lipstick, wild. People post apocalypses, I'ma stop it with this. Apocalypse. In some string quartet, yes, I'm singing alphabet and Corvette. With a high note on every note, showing up on my doorstep. I don't need more stress, I just need endorsements. Indoors is where I forget I'm not living in a tournament. A turn of events is where I forfeit, for the hell of it. No, but spring, I love the smell of it. Think, I love the relevance. Trying to spit up all the shit that people not telling us. Telenovelas, tell us you're celibate. Sell us a skeleton sitting so delicate. Pass it off as a delicate, pass it on like a cigarette. See the smoke in your silhouette, multiplied in mirrors of elephants in the room. In my elements I bloom. Spring, I love the smell of it. Spring, I love the smell of it. Spring, I love the smell of it.
And then...
That was fun. I forgot how much of like rap it really was.
Yeah, I like that song. The production sounded great on it.
Goon Dads started playing, so I just left it on in the background. I'm just talking.
My fair share of hip hop, you know. Gotta have some diversity.
Yeah, that's fun.
Listen to a little bit of everything.
I actually listen to rap a lot. A lot of people diss me because on my Spotify rap, Drake was my number one.
I mean, listen, new Drake stuff, kind of mid sometimes. But Drake is Drake, you know, he got classic tracks.
Yeah, he's Drake. Yeah. Like, I don't know, everybody was, yesterday on, because I run the Woman in Film show on WSVA Radio 2 yesterday, and everybody was clowning on me. Like, there was like four people in here, and they're all clowning on me.
No, there's way worse people to listen to than Drake. Drake's not even bad.
Yeah.
I could actually sit down and listen to him. Some of these rappers, I just can't care for it. Some of the things they promote, it doesn't sit with me, you know? Just, it could be toxic sometimes.
Yeah, agreed.
Yeah.
It do be like that. I got this Goon Dad song in the background. I always get distracted by them. I love their stuff. It's just fun to listen to.
I like the instrumentals.
Oh, yeah. Listen. Yeah, it's fun. But yeah. running out. My brain is turning off. You got something you want to talk about?
I mean,
you're like, I don't know. My name is Matt. That's my Matt impression. Yo, I'm Matt.
Oh, what's going on?
Yo. I don't know. You always have something. You always have like nice stuff to say. This is a nice guy.
I try. Most of the time.
Oh, you. I remember something that I was gonna ask you. You like? Are you like into photography? Is that like a thing?
I mean,
or do you just like appreciate it?
Did I what?
Or do you just like appreciate photography?
Oh no, I mean, I'm into it, but I don't have a nice setup or anything. I don't have a nice camera. I want to get one in the future. Everything I take is on my iPhone, but just like take pictures of things I like to see, you know.
Yeah.
I'd rather post things that are worth seeing on Instagram, you know.
I just remember we were on Dream Girl music video, and we were playing around with the. I had my camera and I was taking BTS pics, and I had this like crinkly, like iridescent clear kind of film.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah, and you kind of put it in front of the lens, and it makes it like rainbowy.
Yeah, I remember we were doing that. That was a nice day too. Honestly, it was like spring. We were out in the field. It made for like such a nice picture. I remember. The music video came out awesome.
Yeah, I got like nice weather. There was like no wind.
Yeah, shout out to you and Tom. Chef that up. For the longest time, though, it's funny. That was actually my background on my phone.
Yeah.
That picture that I took with the iridescent
film. Yeah.
I won't be able to find it, but I'll show you after or something.
That stuff was fun.
Yeah.
I was just wondering. So, yeah. you're just like, bass guy. Matt, the bassist and guitarist.
Yeah, just like playing the bass guitar.
Slay.
I mean, honestly, I started playing it first, so it was just like. It's what appealed to me first. I was like, yeah, the guitar is the guitar, but what about the bass? Nobody talks about that.
Yeah, I love the bass. Oh, I could talk about it forever.
I like that you play it, too.
Yeah, it's fun. I think that, like, something for me is that, like, I get very, like, freaked out doing, like, intricate details. And, like, so, like, when I'm painting something, because I like to paint, like, if I start doing, like, little details and all that, like, I get spazzed out. Like, my hand's like, I don't want to touch it. And then, so that's what I'm like when I'm playing the guitar. Just too many strings. I'm like, ew, I'm spazzing out. And then, like, the bass is just, like, the perfect amount of strings. And they're, like, fatter.
It's got a different, like,
it makes it,
resonance to it.
It just like,
booms.
Yeah.
You feel it. You're supposed to feel it in your chest, you know?
It just makes it, you know, and it's like, it's just like the the way that it like creates like a foundation for things instead of like having to like be the center of attention all the time. It just like, I don't know.
Yeah, exactly. Like, there's not enough love for the basses out there, definitely. Some of them definitely deserve it.
Bass people be like.
But now I feel that, like, starting off on bass and then picking up the guitar, it was like, this feels like a toy almost. This doesn't feel legit. Like, what am I doing?
Yeah. I went, like, the other way. Actually, I started on a ukulele.
That's cool.
Because I was like, nobody wanted, like, I didn't have money, and ukulele was, like, cheap.
Yeah, I want to pick one of those up.
Yeah, they're fun.
The mandolin's pretty cool, too.
Mandolin. I always want to learn banjo. I feel like it's, like, I wouldn't enjoy it, but I want it.
It's fun to play. It's tricky, honestly. We actually put banjo on one of our unreleased songs.
Yeah.
Summer Sometimes. It's coming out in the next few weeks. There's some
little
hints of banjo.
That's what he played.
Andy
played it.
Andy played it last time.
Had a banjo in it?
Mm-hmm. Little hints of banjo.
The banjo lines. The parallel banjos.
The bluegrass lines.
But yeah. What's your favorite book?
Books.
You love books, right? You love to read. You seem like a guy who likes to read.
I definitely did more when I was younger. Like, I like the Harry Potter series. Those books, but I don't read as much anymore.
Which Harry Potter character do you think would win Squid Game? We like found an article before that was like telling like which ones would win, but it actually didn't say anything at all.
Such a cop-out article. They're like, oh yeah, Ron Weasley wouldn't win because he wouldn't be in the first place. And then the next character, I forgot who was.
Yeah, like Hermione. It was like, Hermione is too smart. She would never be in Squid Game in the first place, so she couldn't even possibly win.
It's like, damn.
It's like, girl,
you guys
what?
Are no fun.
Yeah. But who do you think would win Squid Game?
Dumbledore.
Dumbledore?
OG. Gandalf holding it down.
I don't think he would win. I think probably
Yoda.
Yoda. I think it would be like someone who like you wouldn't expect. Like probably like Luna.
Yeah, honestly, she was pretty savage too. She did some crazy stuff in the movies.
Yeah. I feel like she'd be really good.
I haven't seen those movies in a long time though. The I used movies to love them when I was younger.
The movies, they're like Christmas movies. So
I went
like
to the midnight release of the last one when I was young, like what was that, 2010, 2011?
Yeah,
I was so hyped. Me and my whole family went to the midnight release.
I wasn't into it at the time. Do you know what I did see the release of though, which is really funny? I saw the release of the last Twilight movie.
Oh yeah,
but I never seen any of the other Twilight movies.
Oh no,
me and my mom, we went to go see something and I forgot what it was, and then we ended up watching Twilight, and because like the other one was like they ran out of tickets. It was at the atrium, so like they ran out of seats, and then we were like, well, what's the other one that's out? They're like, Twilight Breaking Dawn Part 2. We're like, what?
Sorry guys.
Like, sorry, you can't go see Epic Avatar 1. You have to see it. No, it wasn't Avatar. It was something else. I don't know. But that was fun.
I don't think I've ever seen those movies. I saw, like, part of the last one.
You need to watch Twilight.
Twilight?
You need to watch it. Just the first one. I feel like if you watch it, I feel like you would appreciate the cinematography for some reason. I feel like you'd go, wow, that shot was really interesting. I feel like you would say that.
Yeah, I mean, they seem like they're well-made movies. I mean,
I don't know, people are haters.
They got a lot of hate in their time, definitely.
And I remember you would definitely like, be like Team Edward.
Nah, Team Jacob all the way. Come on.
Wow. But yeah,
that's a throwback right there.
I don't know. We were running out of time. Crying just as we got comfortable.
For real.
Yeah, we're all like ear in the beginning, and now it's like, oh well,
we could finish out with one more song.
Yeah, we're gonna finish out with one more song. Thank you so much for being on the show.
Thank you for having me. Yeah, I appreciate it.
It was fun.
It's awesome that you do this.
It was a nice chill time.
It was pretty chill.
Yeah, it was pretty chill.
Got to listen to some good music, some good bands.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so follow Staten Island Locals at Staten Island Locals on Instagram. Follow me, I'm the host, Emily Casey, at I Have Lil Bones, Lil Like a Rapper.
Give him a follow.
What do you want to promote?
Follow me on Instagram, that's all I got, really. Matt Foronjy.
What about the band?
The Parallel Lines, the Parallel, our last account actually got hacked. So follow us there on Instagram, all one word. We'll be on there. And we'll be on more stuff soon, too. TikTok, everything. We're coming for you. So we'll see you next time.
TikTokers?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. What's going to be our last song? We can play a Parallel Line song.
Oh, well, we got our new single.
Oh, yeah. Well, we're here.
Well, here we are.
Yep. Oh. Well, we're here. Yeah, same thing.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Yeah, listen, new single, Well, Here We Are. And probably listen to it like when you're sad or something, because it'll definitely
hit a little bit more mellow.
It'll
it's a good
hit.
Track though.
But yeah, peace out.
Thanks for tuning in.
Yeah.
Love
bye,
ya.
Deke. Bye, Deke.
Peace.
Sick and tired of singing the same tune. Just never thought that I'd be singing about you. But here we are, here we are. And do I do it to myself? I'm slipping again. But your friend in the
judge of me. And maybe I'm the judge of me. And maybe you're the judge of me. And maybe I'm the judge of me. It's right behind my eyes, and maybe you can see what I can see. It's right behind my eyes, and maybe you can feel what I can feel. It's right behind my heart, so maybe you can see what I can see.